This week on The Wire, ABS data confirms migration, RBA won't act on house prices, and banks back new lending laws. G'day guys, my name's Tim Guest. Welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate where you can get all the top stories happening this week in real estate, finance, investment, and more. Let's kick it on off with our top story for this week. ABS data confirms migration. So Australia's two biggest cities have witnessed the biggest loss of people into the regions on record. Now the ABS has confirmed that the exodus to affordable lifestyle trend with the release of quarterly figures showing the movement of people around Australia. Now economists are calling the escape to the regions a stampede, and overwhelmed real estate agents are calling the demand on regional properties a boom. CoreLogic data shows regional home prices on average rose 8% over the year to January, which was the biggest jump in 16 years. Now the ABS data shows capital cities saw their biggest quarterly loss of people from internal migration on record, with just over 11,000 people leaving capital cities and moving to regional areas. Sydney had a net loss of 4,700 people to the rest of the state, building on the 3,700 from the previous quarter. Melbourne also had a net loss of 4,700 people to the rest of the state. Now Brisbane went against the trend with a net gain of 230 people from the rest of the state, while Perth had a net gain of 710 people. Now guys, for our next story, RBA won't act on house prices. So RBA Governor Philip Lowe has said the Reserve Bank is not responsible for targeting house prices after questions were raised about the creation of a boom market against the backdrop of low interest rates. Philip Lowe said in front of a Parliament's Standing Committee on Economics, I should say, the RBA does not and should not target house prices. Instead, our focus is on the lending that is used to purchase housing. Questioned about the point at which the RBA will act to prevent the creation of unsustainable prices, Lowe said the issue for the central bank would be if people didn't borrow sensibly. He said we shouldn't try to control asset prices. What we can influence is how much borrowing happens on the back of those rising prices. We would be concerned if there would be a deterioration in these standards, but there are few signs of this at the moment. Last week, the RBA confirmed that it will keep the cash rate at 0.1% and revealed that the interest rate will likely remain at record lows until 2024 at least. Now guys, for our final story of the week, banks back new lending laws. So the big banks claim the planned rollback of responsible lending laws will help customers, saying it will lead to faster loan approvals by cutting the amount of detail consumers must provide on their living expenses. The federal government is proposing changes that would mean banks are no longer subject to responsible lending obligations. It says it will make it faster for consumers to access credit, while borrowers will still be protected through other regulations on banks and redress schemes. Now, Commonwealth Bank, Westpac, and National Australia Bank have backed the changes, saying they will remove barriers to credit. NAB says it will continue to assess if customers can repay their loans without falling into hardship. It says lending currently is being slowed down by requirements for banks to collect too much information about customers' living expenses. CBA says banks are currently asking for more information that customers find burdensome to provide, but the data does not provide a useful guide on a customer's ability to repay a loan. Well guys, they're the top stories happening this week. Now, please don't forget to like, comment, and share this video, and follow or subscribe wherever you're seeing this. Have a great week, and remember, there's only one thing in life that makes a difference, that's action. Thanks a lot. Bye for now.